Welcome all dear students. I am Professor Shraddha Firke, Assistant Professor in Computer Science from the KK Bagh Arts Commerce Science and Computer Science College, Kaka Saheb Nagar, Ranwal. Today we are going to study System Programming in which this macro programs. So let's start with this macro programs. We will start with this macro programs. SMACO is what? A simulating a simple machine. That is a SMACO. SMACO is not a real machine, but it is an hypothetical machine or a simple machine and used to illustrate the features of the assembler. SMACO machine can access only 1000 memory locations. That is, it starts from 000 up to only 999. Each instructions of this SMACO is a decimal number whose first digit is an opcode. So each and every instruction of a SMACO is what in the digital form. When we are converting the SMACO assembler program into a machine code, then the SMACO converted into a digital form and its first digit will be always an opcode, which is for the given instruction. The machine has only four internal registers that are known as a general purpose registers and which will be used to store the data elements during the processing. The general purpose registers are A register, B register, C registers and D register. Now let's see which are the different registers in SMACO. The registers are the internal memory storage locations used to speed up the processor operations, which will be storing an internal format of our data. So which are the different registers? The first register is instruction register, that is a IR register, which will be used to store an instructions in the decimal form before the execution. The second one are general purpose registers. There will be a four general purpose registers used to store the data temporarily during the execution of any instructions. The registers are A register, B register, C register and D register, and their code will be 1, 2, 3 and 4 respectively. These four general purpose registers will be used in the assembler program or this SMACO program, which will be holding some data, because any data cannot be processed directly. So we can never access the variables directly. So we have to store the data into the registers and then we can manipulate the data. So therefore these registers are used. Now the next we will study, what are the condition codes? The condition codes specifies the relational operations used to check the conditions. When we are writing a SMACO program, then sometimes we will need to check some conditions between two variables or any different situations. So in that time, these condition codes will be used. So what are the mnemonics for the conditional codes? What are the codes and what is the meaning of that code? For meaning of that mnemonics, we will see. So LT is having a code 1, which will be used if the operand 1 is less than operand 2. That is used to check the less than condition. Then less than equal to, that is LE, the code will be 2. It is used to check when the operand 1 is less than or equal to operand 2. Then third will be EQ. EQ is for equal to, to check the equal to condition between two operands, and its code will be 3. Then GT, that is a greater than, and the code will be 4. GE, that is a greater than equal to, the code will be 5. And any is for unconditional transfer. Just like go to statements or jump statements, when we have to jump for unconditionally, then we will use any statement and its code will be 6. So these are some different 6 mnemonics and 6 conditional codes used for different condition checking. The next are instruction sets. Which are the different instructions used in this SMACO program? We will see. It is a group of commands that the processor understands in terms of the opcodes. So these are some instructions or the commands that will be used in the program to in the form of their opcodes. So there are total 11 mnemonics and their opcodes and their meaning. These mnemonics are some instructions which was given to the assembler when we are writing the program. So these instructions are stop for 00, add 01, sub 02, might 03, move R is for 04. So move R is used when we have to assign the contents of the memory to the register. When we have to assign some memory content to the register, that is some variables to the registers, then we have to use the instruction move R. Then in reverse, move M. It will assign the contents of the registers to the memory location and its code is a 5. Then COMP, that is compare. It will compare both operands and set the condition codes. The conditions code that we have studied earlier and the code is 6. BC is for branch on condition. This statement is used when we have to jump for unconditionally to any location. Then the BC statement will be used and its code is 07. Then div. Div is for divide first operand by the second and its code is 08. Read is the instruction to read any number from the standard input and its code is a 09. And print is the condition, print is the statement which we have to use to print the output on the standard output device and its code is 10. And all these instructions are known as imperative statements. Imperative statements are the mnemonics that are used during the program execution. Apart from the above instruction sets, there are some more directives or declaratives as the assembler directives which we are going to study in the assembler are start and end. These two statements are known as assembler directives. So what is a start? Start will put the next instruction at the specified address, as start 100 or start 200. This will indicate that we have to start our program from this location, and end will end our program or terminate our program. Then there are some declarative statements which are known as declarative statements. First one is DS. DS is for declare storage and it will reserve the location of the data as specified by the operand field. Just like ADS1. A is what? A memory component. DS is to store its location and what is the length is 1. This statement indicates that A is reserved one memory location in the memory. Then the DC statement. DC statement is used to treat the variable or the value as a constant. It is a declare constant. So treat the operand value as a constant and it will store it into a current location. So for example, 10, DC 10. This means the 10 variable is storing the value 10 and it is a constant value and its length is only 1, but it is storing the constant value 10 into this memory location. Then we have to study what is the instruction format for the simple machine or the SMACO. So there is a SMACO instruction which is into 6 different parts including sign. Sign is an optional part, but the instruction format has different 6 digits. It contains 6 different digits and these are parted into 3 different parts. The first 2 are the opcode or the mnemonics which we have studied earlier. These instructions are converted into an opcode of 2-digit opcode. Then the third one is used for register operand or condition code operand. And remaining last three digits are the memory operand, where the variables are stored or the memory addresses of the variables are defined. So the memory instruction or the machine instruction contains total six digits, among which the first two are the instruction codes. Then the next third digit is the register operand or the condition code, and the last three digits are representing the memory operand, where the variables are stored. The memory location of the variables is accessed. Now let's see some simple SMACA program for the addition of two numbers. Now we have parted this instruction or the program into three different parts. Here we will write our mnemonic program or this SMACA program. Then here there is a location counter and we will convert it into an opcode, that is a machine code. So we will write a SMACA program for the addition of two numbers. First we will start with start instruction. This will indicate that we have to start our program from the 100 memory location. Then we will read two different numbers for the addition. Then read X and read Y. X and Y will be two different numbers that we have to add it. As we have seen that we cannot add two different memory locations directly. So we have to add some variable into a register for the data processing. So we are using move R instruction that will indicate we have to move this memory location into a register. So move R, A register and X. Then we will add the contents of the A register with Y, so that we can add the indirectly the X and Y, because A register contains the value of X and we are adding the value of Y into A register. Now we have got the addition of X and Y into this A register. Now we will move it into our result variable. So move to memory, that is move M, A register comma RES, that is result. Now we have got the result. Now we will print that result by using print and register. Oh sorry, result. Then here we are stopping our execution and now start with declarations. So XDS1 is to declare this variable X and its length is 1. YDS1, same Y has a length 1 and result DS1, and this will end our program. Now we have to assign the location counters, that is LC, to all these instructions. So this is how we will assign the location counters to each and every instruction. We have to start from the 100. So the first memory location will start with the 100 and we will increment it 1 by 1. So to 101, 102 up to 106 with the stop. Then we will see the declarations. Here all are having length 1. So we will increment this by 1 by 1. 106, then 107, 8, 9 and 10. So whenever there are any assembler directive statements, that is start and end, then there is no LC processing. No with the start and no with the end. Only the LC processing comes to the your instructions or your imperative or declarative statements. Then we have to convert this mnemonic program into an opcode, that is machine code, for which we will be needed this mnemonic table. So we will convert each and every instruction into a machine instruction. First, it is an assembler directive statement, so we will skip it. Then read X, for which we have to convert this instruction into a six digit opcode. So for the read instruction, there is a code 09. So we have added it into here. There is no third operand here, that is no register or no condition code is used, so therefore it is 0. And the X variable has a memory location 107, therefore here comes 107. Now the next instruction, read y. So read instruction has the code 09. Then there is no register or condition code, so 0. And for the y, the memory location is 108. So therefore, here comes 108. Next instruction, move r. Move r has the code 04. So therefore, here is a 04. We have used a register in this instruction. The a register has a code 1. Respectively, a register has 1, b register has 2, c has 3, and d register has a 4. So here we have added 1. Then the x has the memory location 107. Then here comes 107. For the next instruction, add 0, 1 is the code for add. Then for a register there is 1, and for y 108. So here comes 108. Then for move m instruction, there is a code of 05. Then for a register it comes 1, and the register is 109. So there comes 109. Then last instruction, print is used, print having the code 010, it is 10. Then the register operand is 0, and the register result has the memory location 109. Then the stop instruction has the opcode 00, and there is no further instruction, so therefore 0 and 000. Then all will be zeros. So this is how the memory mnemonic program, that is your SMACO program, is written. Then the LC processing is done, and finally it is converted into an opcode. So this is how your simple SMACO program for the addition of two numbers is done. Okay, thank you so much for today's lecture. We will be coming with the next interesting topic in next video. Thank you.